When Alexander left what would become Alexandria, he traveled to the west along the Mediterranean coast, and then he turned south into the Sahara Desert. That's the same route that we're taking, and for the same reason. He was headed towards a temple at a place called Siwa. Now, in Alexander's time, that's part of Libya. Today, that's part of Egypt. Siwa had a temple to Amun, which was very, very popular, very prestigious in its day. It was like the Delphic Oracle. And the temple to Amun, which is the way that the Berbers out in that area pronounced it instead of Amun, which is the way the Egyptians pronounced it, they were expecting Alexander. Alexander got lost in a sandstorm, but he found his way out and made it to the temple. Well, when he did, he was greeted by the temple priest, who spoke a little bit of Greek, but apparently not very well. You see, the priest intended to welcome Alexander on behalf of the god, but instead, he welcomed Alexander as a god. Well, that impressed Alexander considerably, because he could add it to his reasons for why he was Pharaoh of Egypt. Because the pharaohs were always considered to be gods. Now, he spent some time at Amun, and then he left. There is one other thing about Amun that I want to mention. And that is, it is also the source for the word ammonia. You see, crystals of Amun, which are used to make ammonia, were first discovered at this temple. Oh, and I told you we were coming back to Alexander's tomb. For a very long time, it's been assumed that his tomb might be at Siwa. The reason for that is because in Roman times, there was a Roman by the name of Quintus Curtius Rufius. And Quintus says that Alexander, on his deathbed in Babylon, expressed a desire to be buried at Siwa. Since then, about a decade ago, there was an archaeologist that claimed to have found his tomb here at Siwa, but other archaeologists have disagreed. The local tourism promoters last year in 21, they also said that his tomb was located here at Siwa, but that's not very well accepted either. In any event, Alexander may be at Siwa. Come to think of it, it's very likely that Cleopatra is buried someplace near Alexander. And for that matter, do you know that we don't know the location of any of the Ptolemy's tombs? They're probably all in the same location, which might be Siwa.
So if crystals of Amun were discovered here, how and when were they discovered? I've heard several explanations, one of which is that the crystals were discovered at the temple in the chimneys, or in another case, it was in camel's dung. But I talked to an archaeologist, and this is where the crystals of Amun come from. It's the Salt Lake. At about 4 feet under the surface, some of the crystals are actually ammonia crystals and not so much salt crystals. The crystals were originally used to reduce the smoke from lamps. We're going up to the top of a hill where the old city of Shalleh was built. It was built in the 13th century. But in the 1930s, it suffered from a series of very heavy rains, and being mud brick, well, it didn't survive. Now, you've probably already noticed something that's a little bit odd. Shally's in Siwa, and Siwa is a very large oasis. But there's something that you probably didn't expect to see out in the desert, even at an oasis, at least not at the scale that you're seeing it now. When you take a look at a desert oasis, what you expect to see is something more like this. But that's not the case with Siwa. Siwa is large, very large, and it has a great deal of groundwater. And the result is there are 300,000 trees at Siwa. Oh, and incidentally, this is a photograph from Shally of the Oracle Temple in the distance. Also from Shally, you can see the local cemetery, the Mountain of the Dead. The people that are buried at the top of the mountain tend to be wealthy or more prominent. This is the high rent district intended to keep the hoi polloi out.
We're at Siwa, this time at the Mountain of the Dead. And that's the mountain behind me. And usually the people that are most wealthy, that have the most amount of fame, are going to be buried near the top. Now, one of the reasons that we're here is because there is a story that Alexander the Great wanted to be buried at Siwa. Now, we know that, in fact, he was buried at Alexandria, but then his body disappeared. And it is possible that he was reburied here at Siwa somewhere. Now, two archaeologists have indicated that they thought they found Alexander the Great's tomb here at Siwa. Both of them have been proven wrong.
Now it's time for us to go out into the real desert, the sand dunes. When you're out in this desert, you might run across things that you might not expect. After all, it was under the ocean at one time, and there is evidence of that.